It's an extraordinary tale of daring and sacrifice. It's an extraordinary tale of daring and sacrifice, of rags to riches. And just as Maria Sharapova was about to write the final chapter of her glittering tennis career, the most unexpected plot twist.
I made a huge mistake. I don't want to end my career this way.
Maria! You know her as iconic, confident, and successful, both on and off the court. But it wasn't always that way for the Russian tennis star.
I arrived at the Miami International Airport. I was 6.5 years old with just my father and $700 in his pocket. And we just arrived from Moscow. And we were on a mission to find a tennis academy in Florida because he had read in magazines that that was the place to go to develop a tennis talent.
Learning English from kids' TV shows and bouncing from one academy to another, the young Maria Sharapova was very much an outsider.
I felt very much isolated in what I was doing, and in a way it became a habit and it became so repetitive that I didn't even notice it, but it was absolutely lonely in those times.
In the years ahead, Serena Williams would become her nemesis on the court, and from an early age, Sharapova modeled her career on she and Venus, the prodigious Williams sisters, but she says she never wanted them to know that.
You've never worshipped her, right? Tell me how you actually first laid eyes on her for the first time at the academy.
Serena and Venus were coming to the academy along with her father to train for a few days. And my father said, you know, you have to go and watch these incredible athletes. He's like, I want you to watch and I want you to just to look in their eyes, to see the desire and the passion, to see how they play the game. And I was like, no. I was like, I don't want them to see me being in the stands. I don't want to give them that satisfaction. And so there's a wooden shed behind the court. And so I went in that shed and I was like peeking through this little hole and just witnessing years of my life before me.
And the biggest moment of her life wasn't far away.
I'm so excited. I never expected anything like this to happen so early in my career.
At the age of just 17, Maria beat Serena Williams in the Wimbledon final, propelling her to global stardom. Nothing would ever be the same again.
My dad partied the night after I won. I went to bed early, and the next morning he came back with just bags of newspapers, and he's like, Maria, your face is on the cover of these papers, and I think it was sort of like, oh, it really happened.
But Sharapova thinks that win came at a price. In her new memoir, Unstoppable, she describes hearing a distraught Williams weeping in the locker room.
Obviously, it was a disappointing loss to her because she was expected to win. I'm sure she expected to win that match, another Wimbledon final. So I think that disappointment, it stirred something up. She didn't want to lose to me again.
You said you feel as though she's never forgiven you because you heard her crying. I mean, you were very descriptive of
yeah.
the way she was crying.
Yeah.
It was very emotional. I mean,
it was. I think it was.
But how do you know for sure that that's how she feels about it?
It's a feeling. It was a moment that I had as a 17-year-old, and it's that feeling that you don't really know what to do in that position because I was happy either way, no matter how that match went, but it just made me realize how much it meant to her.
Another four major titles followed, and Sharapova became the world number one player. But against Serena Williams, who became the most successful player of all time, she barely got a look in, losing 18 of their next 20 matches.
One of the things you say very early in your book is the record you have against Serena after that.
Yeah.
Which is kind of in her favor.
Absolutely.
And
I say she's owned me,
right?
Which she has.
But nothing brought more attention on Sharapova than her shock admission in 2016 that she had failed a drugs test. It turned out to be the biggest challenge of her career. Don Riddell, CNN.